Hey everyone, it's Bobby from Lyco Birds with another video in my Bird ID Through the Year series. And this one is going to cover the common species of large birds that travel in flocks in the early spring. And like many of the videos in this series, this is heavily biased towards inland areas, particularly in central Pennsylvania. So if you're too far from there, the species that you might see in your local area could differ a little bit from these. And of course, if all of the birds were as close as they are in these photos, then this wouldn't be a very challenging video, but a lot of times these flocks are a mile or two or more away, so it can get a little tricky to identify them at the distance. And during the early spring, Canada goose is going to be the default species that you see in any dark flocks of birds, and I say dark because the other species we're going to look at are all primarily white. Canada geese often fly in pretty organized V formations, and structurally they have relatively long necks, and if you're a little closer to them, you can often see the white cheek patch standing out on the face. And here's a fairly typical view you might see of a group of Canada geese flying overhead. You can see this V formation with a few straggling birds, but sometimes the V's are pretty tight and sometimes they're a little less organized. We also have another goose that migrates through in big flocks, and that would be snow goose. And snow geese are a little bit smaller than Canada geese are, but the plumage is quite different. They are completely white with dark in the wingtips. And flocks of snow geese are often a little less organized than flocks of Canada geese are, and they don't fly necessarily in tight V formations. A lot of times they form these loose groups like this. And seeing large flocks of snow geese flying around can be an absolutely incredible experience. Snow goose also has a dark morph, which is often called blue morph or blue goose, but they are variably dark, and you can see a survey here of just some of the variation. The adults typically have these clean white heads, and the juveniles are just darker overall. And they are a lot less numerous than the white snow geese, so a lot of times you just see a few of these stuck in with hundreds and hundreds of white snow geese. Next we have tundra swan, and this is the only species of swan that would typically be found in large migratory flocks in eastern North America. But in flight they are strikingly large and white, and the extremely long neck stands out even at pretty considerable distance. So compared to snow goose, you can see the longer neck, and they also don't have any black in the wingtips. And swans in flight overall just pretty unmistakable, and they're really fun to watch. And last we have ring-billed gull. And these have a considerably different flight style than the geese and swans. Geese and swans have a fairly direct flight style, especially when they're migrating. They're really going one direction, and if they're changing directions, it's just kind of turning a little bit. In contrast, ring-billed gulls will often lazily soar around, so they'll actually sort of circle and gain lift to climb. And even when they're flapping, they appear much more buoyant than these other species. The shape is also quite different because gulls have very short necks and very pointed wings compared to geese and swans. And ring-billed gulls can travel in very large groups, but they're usually very disorganized. But on rare occasion, you will see them in sort of more of a V formation. And as you get closer to the coast, the variety of gull species you see will increase, but if you're well inland, at least for me, over 99% of the gulls that I'm seeing are ring-billed gulls. We do have two other gull species that are expected to migrate through, but they are very much outnumbered by ring-billed gulls. And then a number of other gull species will turn up rarely, but that's another topic for another day. And here's what a typical flock of ring-billed gulls look like as they are low on the river. So as spring migration begins, keep your eyes to the skies, and hopefully you will spot some of these flocks, particularly on days with strong south winds. And if you're interested in daily bird ID quizzes and other updates, my email list is lycobirds.com/email. It's free and easy to unsubscribe at any time. And I hope you will join me in my next video. Thanks for watching.